Today, I shall discuss a few applications of the electric field related problems, okay? And you all know it is a huge chapter. There are so many problems to be discussed in this section, but within our small, this type of efforts, I cannot go to such elaborate details into this matter as right now. But today, I am giving two examples on how some familiar problems can be solved using the concept of Coulombic interactions. Okay. Now, first of all, there are two parallel plates separated by a particular distance. Let the lower plate is positively charged, okay, and the upper one, it is negatively charged. The plates are separated by a distance d. Now, let an electron is projected horizontally along the length of the two parallel plates. We assume that the mass of the electron is m and the charge of the electron is e. So the electron is initially projected, with an horizontal velocity u along the length of the two parallel plates. Now, you all know that the electrical lines of force are the imaginary lines. They may be straight or may be curved, and they originate from the positive charge and terminate on the negative charge. As we all know, the charges are uniformly distributed over the surface of the plates. So, and the separation between the plates is also constant throughout their length. So, electric field intensity in between the two plates at any position will be uniform. That means the electrical lines of force in between the plates will be parallel to each other. So, the electric field intensity, let it be represented by E. It is directed along this direction. I can draw an imaginary electrical lines of force. Suppose it will be like this. Okay, the electric field intensity is directed along this direction. Now, as electron is assumed to be of the negative charge, so electron will be attracted by the lower plate in this case, which is assumed to be positive. Let us, for our simplicity, we set up the coordinate axis as it is x-axis and it is our y-axis. Okay, it is our x-axis, it is our y-axis. Now, you all see that if we neglect the force of gravity on the electron, then weight has no effect. Weight of the electron, projected electron, has no effect in this problem, or it will not exert any force along the y direction, neglecting the gravity. So, initial velocity of the electron is perpendicular to the force due to electric field. Force due to electric field is the important factor here, which is the only force in our problem. So, it is acting along the y-axis. Actually, being of the negative charge of the electron, the force is along the negative y-axis. That means the force is along y-axis. So, this force has no component along the horizontal direction. Understood? This force has no component along the horizontal direction. So, along the horizontal direction, there will be no acceleration of the electron. It is just like the projectile motion. No acceleration of the electron. So, the horizontal velocity of projection of the electron will remain constant throughout its motion or at every point of the trajectory or path followed by the electron. Okay. Now, we assume, let the path is like that. We shall establish the path will be parabolic. Let at any point, say at P, the coordinate, I assume that this is our origin, 0, 0. So, the coordinate of the point P, it will be, say it is x, y. Let the coordinate of the point P, it is x, y. I can take minus y also here. Okay, it is x, y. Now, at this position, x is the horizontal displacement of the electron and y is its vertical displacement. Now, in the vertical direction, you all observe that there was no initial velocity of the electron, because the initial velocity of the projection was along x-axis, positive x-axis. So there is no component of u along y-axis. So we can write, applying the kinematics, y equals to, I am taking only the magnitude of the displacement, y equals to half ay into t square, where ay is the acceleration of the electron along y-axis. That is along the direction in which the force acts. And what is acceleration? Acceleration equal to force by mass. What is force? Charge into electric field intensity divided by mass. M is assumed to be the mass of the electron. So y equals to half ee by m into t square. Instantaneous displacement along y-axis. Now, x component of the velocity, that is u, never changes. So in the time at when the electron reaches the point P, it has horizontally traveled the distance of x. Therefore, x equals to u into t. So from this equation, we can substitute the value of t, that is x by u, and put this in this equation. Say it is our equation number 1, it is our equation number 2. So putting the value of t in the equation, we have y equals to half ee by m into x by u, that is squared. That is equals to ee by 2m u square into x. So it is clearly, it is the equation of a parabola, that is y equal to some constant into x square, y proportional to x square. It is the equation of a parabola. So the trajectory or the path followed by the projected electron will be a parabola under this condition. Understood? Okay. Now, you all know that velocity at any point of the trajectory of the particle, charged particle here, is directed tangentially. So, at the point P, the velocity will be directed along this direction. Let it be represented by V. At the point P, the velocity is represented, the tangential direction, let it be represented by V. So, V will have two components, along x-axis and another along y-axis. Okay, now along x-axis it will be u, and along y-axis, say the component is vy. Why along x-axis it is u? I have already stated many times, because u is the horizontal component of velocity, which will not change as there is no horizontal acceleration of the projected electron. Now vy, it is the y component of the velocity of the electron after t second, that is instantaneous at the after t second. Now, initial velocity along y-axis was 0, so it is simply 0 plus ay into t, t in a bit different way, ay into t, that is e by m into t. So, at any moment, the magnitude of the instantaneous velocity, it will be u square plus e by m t whole square. Okay. Let this angle is theta. Let this angle is theta. So clearly tan theta will be Vy by u. So theta, it is our tan theta. It is Vy by u. That means by u. Okay. Now what is t? T equals to again x by u, or tan theta equals to e by mu into x by u. That is, on simplification, it will give you e by mu square. That is theta equal to tan inverse e x by mu square. So theta is not a constant, it varies with x. Okay. Now there will be a moment at which the electron will strike the lower plate. There will be a moment. Let electron strikes the lower plate at point D. Let the electron strikes the lower plate at point D. Okay. Now, at point D, you will all observe that it is the horizon, the vertical displacement at point D, it is simply small d by 2, because it was our d by 2, it is our reference axis. So it is d by 2 clearly. Now, let after time t, the electron, capital T, electron strikes the lower plate at D. Therefore, capital T will be simply, let the length of each plate, I am assuming it is L. Length of each plate, it is L. So T will be L by U, because U is a constant. It cannot change. It is the initial horizontal component of projected electron's velocity. Okay, L by U. Now, here you all observe that let the velocity, it is say V dash in this point. The same as the velocity V dash. Let the electron makes an angle phi with the lower plate. Let this angle is phi. You can all observe this, the figure, let this angle is phi. So what will be our tan phi? Tan phi will be again Vy dash by U. You will be again, you will remain same at every point. Now what is our Vy dash? Vy dash will be again like the previous 0 plus Ay into capital T. That is E by M into capital T means L by U. So tan phi, sorry, this is phi. This is phi. So tan phi, it is nothing but EEL by mu squared. Substituting this value in this equation. So phi equal to tan inverse EEL by mu squared. So, we can conclude that after time L by U, the electron will escape from the electric field in between the existing parallel plates and it will make an angle tan inverse EEL by mu square with the lower plate. Okay, at the moment of escape from the electric field. Okay, up to this, after a moment I shall come with another problem.